In this final video of my three-part series on creating pins with Affinity Publisher version 2, I'm going to talk about bulk generating pins using the data merge feature. Now, this cannot really be combined with the previous video where we swapped out images in bulk, because what will happen is you will end up with the same image on every single pin. So this works best if you just do this from scratch. So first, I'm going to set up my file with my data in it. And so what I've got here is I've got a header that says title 1, title 2, and image. And then I've got in each row my pin titles. So here I've got 9 breakfast ideas. And I've got these separated because I want 9 to be in one text box in a larger size, and then breakfast ideas will be in a different text box at a smaller font size. And then my second one is just wines to try, and as a matter of fact, let's move this, because I don't want this to be huge. Let's move this to title 2, and let's also move cute dogs to title 2. We only want the large numbers to be in our first column. And you can just make it even simpler and just have one title column. That works too. The next thing we need to know is we need to tell Affinity where to find the images. So I'm on a Mac, and there are different ways to do this, but one easy way is to go into your Finder, find the image that you want, right-click it so that you get this little pop-up, hit the Option key, and then you can copy the path name. And then we can bring that into Excel. Just delete this one, and I will replace it. And there you go. There's a similar way to do this on a PC. I am not on my PC right now, so I will try and remember to make a video on that later. But you can also just search for that on the internet, how to copy a path file name in Windows, and you'll be able to find out how to get this complete path for your spreadsheet. So I'm going to save this, and I'll save it as an Excel sheet just so that I have a copy of it, but then I also need to save a copy as an CSV, comma delimited file. So we'll do it as that. I'm going to give it a different name. And that's only because I've kind of done a dry run of this, and so I want to make sure that I'm not confused which file I'm getting. All right, so now let's go into Publisher, and we're just going to set this up. So I'm going to use the Art Text tool, and we will get our 9, and let's change this to, no, not that. So let's do that. That, maybe a little smaller. And then I'm going to use a text box, frame text here. And let's make this a smaller font. Let's start with 64. And we'll do breakfast, return ideas. And we'll give that color. And in my previous ones, we had a little bit of a drop shadow on this. So let's just kind of roughly put those back. Something like that. And close. Okay. So now we have our pin set up. We need one more thing. We need a picture frame. So I'm going to go over to this frame tool. And I am just going to put a picture frame over all of this. And then I'm going to drag it in my layers to the very bottom so that it's underneath my little logo down here. And we are ready to start data merging. So I'm going to go to Window. These things have moved a little bit from version 1. I do have a version 1 video on a prompt journal with data merge. So if you are still on version 1 of Publisher, you might want to look back at that one. The process will be the same, but things are in a little bit different location. So I'm going to go to Window, Data Merge Manager, and down here I want to click on this little plus, and I'm going to find my CSV that I created and open it. And then let's just scroll down. I'm going to do preview with record because that's going to give me an idea of what it's going to look like. I can make some little formatting changes. Now at this point, I'm just going to minimize this and I need to do one more thing. I need to map these items that I just set up, my text and my image, to the different fields in the spreadsheet. So back to window, and this is in a weird place now. It's not obvious. References, fields. And this will bring up my fields manager. And I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom where it will say data merge. It already is linking to my CSV and it brought in the three different fields that I have, title one, title two, and image. So now what I want to do is select my number nine, double click on title one. Now it doesn't look like anything happened because what I set up is really just the first row of my spreadsheet. I'm going to go to breakfast ideas, hit title two, and then I want to select my picture frame here and do image. And that brought my image in. All right, so now we can say, okay, this all looks good. I obviously in my spreadsheet didn't capitalize ideas, but for demonstration purposes, I think we are good to go. So let's go back to our data merge manager. And now we just hit generate and just say yes. And it's going to open a new document where it's going to generate them all. And so now if we bring out our pages, we're done with this. You can see we have nine breakfast ideas with the right image. I've got wines to try, so I can just relocate this. You might need to do some tweaks, but everything's there. 80 books to read. Again, probably want a different color of font here. Cute dogs. And I will just use the move tool to just move that to a different position. And so here we made a bunch of pins in just a few clicks. So once you have this set up, you could save this particular file. And each time you want to go back and make a new one, you would be able to just upload your spreadsheet. And your layout is already there. You just need to make sure that all your fields are properly linked in this field manager. And then you can generate a new set of pins from the same one. So I would save this kind of source one that we set up initially. And then it creates a brand new file when you actually do the merge. So this is where you would actually export your pins from. So, you know, if you have a lot of posts on your blog, you could have a spreadsheet set up with all your post titles and some images. And then another way to swap out images would be to just update your spreadsheet, come back to your source pin, and just rerun your data merge, and you would have a whole set of fresh pins, even for your whole blog if you set it up right. So I hope that's helpful in, again, a little hack that you can use to create content more quickly. Thanks for watching.